segundo capítulo, segunda temporada de Mirá a quién encontré. Hemos vuelto al tradicional sistema de la sillita del escritorio, algo más tradicional, más chiquito, más acotado, pero no por eso hay que desprestigiar la película de la que vamos a hablar hoy, una película que en este 2019 cumple 25 años, con una película que vale verla tanto en castellano como en inglés, y de las dos formas cumple. Tenés que verla alguna vez, por lo menos en un idioma y en el otro, y vas a ver que si bien es la misma película, algo cambia de lo que es la película en sí misma. Yo creo que si lo hiciste me vas a entender, y si no, te aliento a que hagas esto. Vamos a hablar con uno de los protagonistas de esta película, que como decíamos, se estrenó en 1994, cumple 25 años. No quiero adelantar mucho más, pero estuve durante mucho, mucho tiempo buscando a alguien que me pueda hablar de este film, para mí un clásico de la cultura popular. Vamos a ver, fíjate, mirá a quién encontré.
They was my magic shoes.
All right, Forrest. You can open your eyes now.
Those are real, I believe, 1950s era leg braces that were common for like children that had polio. Yes, they keep your legs completely straight. It's difficult to walk in them, so I had to spend time on set, you know, adapting to that. It was fun for me as a kid. I thought it was like a Halloween costume. Breaking off, that was all. Their special effects were set up so that they had little bombs that put the braces off my legs while I was running. So, and actually I remember that scared me as an 8-year-old. They demonstrated the braces exploding to me at one point, and I freaked out and was like, I don't want to do this. You know, I don't even want to do this scene because I was sure it was going to blow my legs off.
Yeah. Are you stupid or something?
I'm as stupid does.
Originally, they had not planned on him speaking with the accent that he speaks with the southern accent that Forrest Gump uses. They had not fully developed that. And then when they cast me, they heard the way I talked as this kid from deep Mississippi with this really thick southern accent. And they were like, we want you to sound like him. So they started putting him with me all the time, and he slowly developed his accent based on mine. So he basically copied my voice.
Are you stupid or something?
Stupid is or stupid does, sir.
When I did Forrest Gump, they filmed the movie near a U.S. Marine Corps air base, and they took me to tour that as a kid because I was into airplanes and helicopters and everything. So they took me out there, and that really got me more inspired to maybe one day be in the military. And then around the time I was a teenager, 18 years old, is when 9/11 happened. And at that point, I had considered being in the military before. However, I was thinking, you know, at first, well, there wasn't a whole lot going on. Then after 9/11, it was pretty much guaranteed that if you joined the Army, you were going to be deployed to Afghanistan or Iraq. And I thought, well, if I'm going to do it, I might as well do it now. I didn't want to be in a war, but I decided had to have that experience, and I wanted to see it too.
Congratulations, son. Have you given any thought to your future? Thought?
Do you remember one day in particular when you thought that, okay, I'm not coming back to the base today?
Somebody turned off the rain, and the sun come out.
I was driving a vehicle, and I ran over a bomb that was buried in the ground, and it went off, and the explosion damaged my vehicle, but it did not hurt anybody in the vehicle. Shortly thereafter, the explosive ordnance disposal crew came through to check the hull and make sure the bomb was fully detonated and whatnot. So they dug into the hull, and they told me afterwards that a smaller bomb had gone off, and it was on top of a much, much larger bomb that was supposed to go off and would have annihilated the entire convoy I was in. And they said they never really figured out why it did not explode. That's one of those things that just kind of sits with you the rest of your life.
Yeah, you know? When you join the army, do people recognize you?
I did not want them to know who I was, because I assumed that, you know, you already get kind of beat up basic training by the drill sergeants psychologically, and I didn't want it to be any worse than it was already going to be, and I didn't want them to single me out.
What's your sole purpose in this army?
To do whatever you tell me, drill sergeant.
God damn it, Gump! You're a goddamn genius.
It took about 3 weeks before one of the drill sergeants, I guess, just recognized me, and he called me out on it, and everybody else found out. But what's funny is that those first 3 weeks, one of the guys I was in training with, he kept coming up to me for the first 3 weeks, and he's like, you know, you look just like that kid who was in the Boy Scout. And I kept telling him, I'm like, you know, I've heard that before. It's coincidence. I know it's funny, isn't it, right? Well, then when he found out I had been in the Forrest Gump, he never believed anything else I recalled after that.
Yeah. Was there a nickname for you because of the movie?
My given name is Benjamin Buford Blue. People call me Bubba.
Yeah, they do. And it's funny because, I mean, people did call me Gump a lot.
My name's Forrest Gump. People call me Forrest Gump.
But it's ironic because they already call people Gump in the Army all the time because of the whole force of Vietnam.
Yeah.
You join the Army and the drill sergeants frequently call somebody Gump. So I heard that all the time when they didn't know who I was. And every time I heard that, I looked over my shoulder thinking, wait a minute, they figure out who I am. Because I was always hearing Gump. Yeah. So, but that name did stick with me for the rest of the Army.
Yeah. Hasta ahí la charla con Michael Conner Humphrey, uno de los protagonistas de esta película llamada Forrest Gump, que como les dije y les vuelvo a repetir, tienen que verla por lo menos una vez en latino y una vez en inglés. Incluso las frases populares de la película no son las mismas, si bien significan lo mismo, no son literalmente las mismas, y la versión doblada para mí ha logrado imprimirle su identidad, así que vale mucho la pena. Más que interesante ver el paralelismo entre el protagonista de esta película y el actor Michael, que tuvo una vida bastante similar a la de Forrest Gump. No te vayas sin dejarle un me gusta, sin compartir esta nota que tanto orgullo me da haber hecho y que tan contento me pone finalmente haber cumplido este objetivo. Nosotros por lo pronto nos vemos la semana que viene. There are things that in the movie are that transcend the screen and now are real things that, like Bubba Gump.
Hold on there, boy. Are you telling me you're the owner of the Bubba Gump Shrimp Corporation?
Yes, sir. We got more money than Davy Crockett.
Well, I have gone to Bubba Gump restaurant before, once, just to see what it was like, and I didn't want to spend too much time in there because my picture is all over the restaurant, so I didn't want to sit there too long and then realize who I was, and then I just knew that would just turn into a big thing or whatever. So I went in there to try to